Hello, I'm Dr. D. Sarala. Today I would like to have some light thrown upon this Sustainable Development Goals 2030 of UN, which is being held at 7th International Conference on Interdisciplinary Research for Sustainable Development. I am Head Department of Physics and Electronics from St. Anne's College, Hyderabad, Telangana State. And it is an autonomous affiliated to Usmania University College, and it is NAC accredited with A plus grade in the third cycle and college with potential for excellence. So let us discuss about these goals. There are many goals for the sustainable development goals, but we would like to concentrate mostly on quality education. And there are four targets here to provide primary secondary education completely free and equal access to all technical, vocational and higher education, increase the number of people with relevant skills for financial success, universal literacy and numeracy. So out of these, I would like to concentrate on the skill enhancement, continuous evaluation, analytical and critical thinking skills, ICT integration and promotion of online MOOC courses, which we've been practicing. I've been teaching for the past three and a half decades at UG, PG level, both physics, electronics, computer science, management, and I'm also an ICT integrator. I have my own YouTube channel and involved in many quality education measures at our institution, steering committee member for National Assessment and Accreditation Council. I was a Dean Academics. So with this, let me just give you an overall view of what I have done. So before we start with the education policy, we are halfway into it. A few of these measures we have adopted. So we are only trying to link ourselves with this vision of the educational policy given by the Government of India. This is a system where it contributes to equitable and vibrant knowledge society, and it should provide quality education to all. Skill-based education and instilling values. We also have various skill-based courses, certificate courses, career-oriented courses, finishing schools, value education to instill values, human values, etiquette and manners, professional image building, NCCNSS for the national building, and Center for Women's Studies, Legal Literacy Services. These are all the things we have been doing it, so we ourselves can tune with it. We also have a responsible citizen UN, mock UN celebrations. They will be representing the college at national and state levels. And we also do support to the sustainable development and global citizen, because our vision of the college is academic excellence, skill enhancement, and women empowering the girl child. So we have these courses: care for the elderly, calligraphy, cosmetology, hardware and networking, MS Office, web designing, photography, robotics, the Department of Physics, for which I am the head. We have designed and made the students learn the different programming concepts of Arduino, open source, Python, for designing different moving robots, the line follower, obstacle avoider, and many more. Now, due to corona pandemic, we've also designed some small robotics for automatically dispensing the sanitizers, reading the body temperatures touchless, and maintaining a social distance by using different probes and different sensors, which gives a kind of whistle or alarm saying that the distance of minimum 3 feet is not being maintained. And then touchless and monitoring, video monitoring of medicine dispensing by using robotics. Our digital photography is yet another very interesting course. The students are taught the nuances of this digital SLR photographies, and they are the ones who take all the events covered in the college, and all their work is posted onto the college website. We have web designing course. Students do design websites of the different departments. professional image building and etiquette is another very popular course. Bakery cooking also is there. Cosmetology, all these courses are job potential courses. Some of them are starting with their own small business. So basically, the key principles of the NEP is community participation. We do some outreach. We conduct medical camps, eye camps to all the slums and neighboring colonies. Students of the government college will be visited by our student volunteers, and they will be demonstrated many experiments, of science experiments. They will be taking their English classes and so on. So that, you know, it's a kind of leadership development skill for our students, and also we are benefiting to the neighboring community. This is one aspect that we are working on. Then we are talking about the use of technology. Extensively it is being used. We have our own e-resources, YouTube channels, and we do flipped class, hybrid learning, and this has been a boon for us during the COVID 19 pandemic, because we've used them, and that sudden transition from offline to online did not interrupt much of our teaching, because partly we are into it. And we do continuous review of the classes, the assessment. So not the rote learning. We do have quizzes, internships, presentations, projects. They will be continuously assessed. They will be taken a viva. Each and every experiment in the practical science laboratories are monitored, evaluated. So, and then we have end semester examinations, which are at the end of each semester it will be conducted. We also have advanced learner programs. Extra credits are given for them through UGC, MOOCs and SWIM. They will be taking these courses. And many staff members are also taking these courses. And I happen to be the coordinator for this. And we are receiving an active coordinator certificate from IIT Chennai continuously for the past many years. Many students have received gold medals, silver medals. And all the students are taking these courses as a faculty development program. So they are also continuously upgrading and updating their knowledge. So this is education at all levels. And curriculum is divided, not totally reduction. This is a policy of the government. What we do is we divide them into 70% of instructional methodology given by the instructor, and then a few percent for self-learning, self-exploration, experiential learning. And we also make them apply their critical thinking skills, interactive sessions in the classes, that also we do encourage. And we want to transform teaching learning process more towards student learning process. And we would like to give, we all have our own YouTube channel. Our content is well planned and prepared and posted into the Google Classrooms and social media networks. We have our own website where our e-resources are deposited. Students have access for all this. We tell them, we give them a schedule, they learn little, they go through the video lessons, they go through the assignments that is given. When they come back, we discuss them. So they watch the videos at home, come here and do the exercise. Like classwork is done at home, homework is done in the classes. So this is one thing which we are working out. This is already discussed about the assessment. I told you we were attending many faculty development programs. Before COVID, we were attending them offline. During COVID, it is completely webinars, and umpteen number of courses, umpteen number of training programs, workshops we are conducting for others, and at the same time, we are also upgrading ourselves by attending many premier institutions. And SWIM is another platform. Where our students, I told you, are already registered, and we are pursuing for the past 7 years we are doing it. And there is one language processing, that is they want to convert this video content into 8 IITs and IIMs, it's a consortium. They have translated them into 8 Indian languages, all the videos. I happen to be contributing myself as a review and transcripted the video content into the languages, and is made available on their website so that it reaches all the rural students as well. So they want to increase their enrollment by 50% and then by 2035. and the multiple entry and exit points they want to create. So we are working towards it. We have 1 year certificate programs, 3 year degree programs, 2 year postgraduate programs, planning to go for 4 years honors degree as well. And in academic bank of credits, per se, we are also doing that. So some credits, some electives which they learn from these MOOCs are given due weightage, and we give them extra credits. All those students who have completed and successfully done this course full-fledged, that is 8 weeks and 12 weeks. So that is also taken care of. We will strengthen it further. Then this is going to be called as a single umbrella for all these, and all the UG colleges are going to be autonomous or constituent. They have some four verticals, namely regulatory councils, education councils, grants council, and till now it was called as NAC, that is National Assessment and Accreditation Council. I think now it's going to be renamed as National Accreditation Council for Accreditation. So we are already part of it, we are into it, and we'll continue. And then inclusive education. So we have provided them with visible friendly classrooms, ramps and lifts, and ours is a multi-storied building. So few classes where there are children who are challenged physically, we shift the classrooms for their convenience. A lift is also done, lift is also being raised. Where it is not much of a height, we have a ramp where their wheelchairs and all can easily be processed. We provide the help provision of our scribes, fee concessions and lower pass percentage as per the university guidelines. Mobiles and laptops, tablets, most of them will be getting. We are planning, we will do it slowly. So BEd degree, VAS is basically a postgraduate undergraduate college. We have many qualified, competent, professionally PhD holders, postdoc faculty. So since it's a higher education institution, continuously we have a meritorious students, and most of the students are awarded the best teacher award by the state government of Telangana. Educational technologies are extensively used. We have our own whiteboards, interactive boards and audio visual centers, seminar halls equipped with multimedia facilities. We have a recording facility, Drushya, where each lecturer is expected to go record, self-record the content, upload it to the YouTube. The evaluation process, these are the thrust of areas. To remove language barriers, I already told you we have done a few of the translation studies. We want to increase educational access. Mostly the students are using mobile devices, so mobile learning is going on. And we would like to little more add artificial intelligence. We have not yet done. We want to scale up little more in this direction. So robotics, we have done simulations in Department of Physics and Electronics, zoology, where there is a ban for physical dissection of the animals. They are doing virtual simulations. They use a visualizer and then do it. And the physics department, most of the experiments are done. We have purchased a licensed software. We enable the students to simulate and get an overall view of the experiments. These are all the future scope for all these things. Healthcare, climate change also. We have an eco club which conducts various competitions, awareness camps, essay writing competitions, webinars, and then student-centric activities to bring about this awareness. So during all the Indian festivals, the culture, Sanskriti club is there that will give awareness on various festivals of the Indian subcontinent. And clay modeling and the importance of saving the nature, that is going on. Healthcare, I already told you, we conduct many camps for faculty and students of our college, for neighboring people, for all these auxiliary staff and for all those helpers, the drivers, the gardeners, and then adjacent colony people, the servants made. All these people, their health care is continuously being monitored. Various camps are conducted on special days. So we do play, hope to play a very good role as a higher education institutions leverage the technology, ICT-based education, and then online education we want to improve. We are doing already online assessment using Google quizzes, then Google Forms, online quizzes, online platforms. We use our interactive video lessons, Edpuzzle, many more we will explore in the years to come. So this is what virtual laboratories is another thing that we are concentrating on. During the pandemic, the science departments have extensively used the highest number of logins from the college, and we are attached to IIIT Hyderabad, and we are the nodal center. We do conduct awareness camps, orientation programs for the other colleges as well. So with this, I come to an end of my presentation. Thank you so much.